Now we'll take a look at some examples of adding polynomials. In our first example, we have the sum of four monomials. The main thing to remember about adding polynomials is that we can only add like terms or terms that have the exact same variable factor. So for example, 15x and negative 9x are like terms. They both contain one factor of x. And 4y and 7y are like terms because they contain one factor of y. To combine or add like terms, we add the coefficients and the variable factor stays the same. So for example, to add 15x and negative 9x, we would have 15 plus negative 9 times the factor of x. And then to add the y terms, we would have 4 plus 7 times the factor of y. And since 15 plus negative 9 is 6, we would have 6x. And since 4 plus 7 is 11, we'd have plus 11y. Now if you do a few of these, you'll probably skip this step here and then perform this addition mentally. On the second example, we have the sum of two binomials. So to clear these parentheses, we could think of putting a 1 here and distributing a positive 1. But the nice thing about addition is that if we distribute a 1, it's not going to change the sign of anything, so we can just drop the parentheses. So this would just be negative 9x plus 7 plus x. Now we could write this as plus negative 5, but it's more common just to write minus 5. And now we'll identify the like terms. Here's an x term, and here's an x term, and here are two constants. One more thing that can be helpful is, for this x, we could write this as 1x. So now to combine the x terms, let's see if we can skip this step here. We would have negative 9x plus 1x, and since negative 9 plus 1 is negative 8, we'd have negative 8x. And then this would be a positive 7 minus 5, which is positive 2, so we have plus 2. Again, for our third example, we can just drop the parentheses when we have addition, or we can think of distributing a positive 1 in both cases. So we'd have negative 12y to the third plus 15y to the fourth plus 3y to the fourth. And again, we could write this as plus negative y to the third or just minus y to the third. Let's go ahead and put a 1 in here. Again, we'll identify the like terms. Here we have two y cubed terms. And here we have 2y to the fourth terms. Let's combine the terms of the highest degree first. So 15y to the fourth plus 3y to the fourth. Since 15 plus 3 is 18, we have 18y to the fourth. And then for the y cubed terms, we have negative 12y cubed minus 1y cubed. And since negative 12 minus 1 is negative 13, we'll have negative 13y cubed, which we'll write as minus 13y cubed. We could write plus negative 13y cubed, but this is much more common. And then for the last example, we'll go ahead and put 1s here and distribute, but we know when it's addition, distributing a positive 1 is not going to change the sign of anything. This will be different when we deal with subtraction. So we'll have 2a squared minus 3a minus 1 plus a squared plus 9a and then minus 1. So here we have 2a squared terms. Here we have 2a terms. And here we have two constant terms. So looking at the a squared terms, we have 2a squared plus 1a squared, that would be 3a squared. Now here we have a minus 3a, which would be the same as plus negative 3a, so we're going to think of this as negative 3a plus 9a, and since negative 3 plus 9 is positive 6, we'll have plus 6a, and this would be negative 1 minus 1, that's negative 2. So we have minus 2. Next, we'll take a look at subtracting polynomials.